Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Fallout 4's DLC, Far Harbor. This video is going to be a walkthrough guide in which I will show you how to acquire the unique baseball bat known as Fencebuster. And of course, to acquire this weapon, you will need the Far Harbor DLC installed. Now, the first time we arrive in Far Harbor, at some point, we will be approached by this robot, Pearl. She will ask us if we are the investigator she's been looking for, and you want to say yes. And of course, continue to say yes and help her out. Pearl would then ask us to follow her, which of course we want to do. Eventually, she will lead us to the Cliff's Edge Hotel. And just a warning, the Cliff's Edge Hotel is filled with ghouls. I literally could not believe how many damn ghouls were in this place. There is at least 30 ghouls here, so of course be sure to come well equipped and prepared for a battle with 30 plus ghouls. Now of course continue to follow Pearl. Eventually she will lead us into Vault 118. And once down here, all of her robotic friends will lead us to the atrium, in which there is a dead body for us to inspect. I don't want to spoil the questline, so all I'll say is follow the blood trails on the floor, and then over in the corner of the atrium, we will find the Fencebuster, just lying there all alone. But just be careful when you're picking it up, you don't want to get busted. As always, before looking at the weapons base stats, I have reduced all of my character's special attribute stats to 1. I also have no bobblehead perk or magazine effects applied to my character. What this means is we will be seeing the absolute minimum base stats of the weapon. Now for maximum damage, you want to add the bladed modification, which makes targets bleed and adds exceptional damage. And secondly, you want to add the aluminium frame. This will also increase the damage. Now once those modifications have been applied, we have a base ballistic damage of 34, its speed is slow, its weight is 3.9 pounds, and its value is 144 caps. As we can see up the top there, Fencebuster ignores 30% of the target's damage and energy resistance. Interesting. Now, as I'm sure you'll notice throughout these killing sequences, purely for visual purposes, I did not go with the aluminium frame and the bladed modification. But as we know, if you want maximum damage from this weapon, you will have to go with those previously mentioned mods. Okay, so Fencebuster, what's going on with the old Fencebuster? Not too much, to be honest. There are no bugs to speak of, which is excellent. As we know, Fencebuster is a unique baseball bat, and sadly, they still haven't changed the baseball bat speed to medium instead of slow. Because hey, let's face it, I reckon I could swing a baseball bat pretty quickly. Also, with a base damage of 34 when fully modded out, that might seem like a pretty high base damage, which I suppose it is. Once getting all the appropriate perks, I could only get the damage up to about 84, 86. Which isn't too bad, but then of course, remember it's a slow swinging weapon, so you're only going to be doing 86 damage like every 3 or 4 seconds. So straight away, it's a very average melee weapon. Now its legendary effect, this ignore 30% of the target's damage and energy resistances, is applied by the legendary effect penetrating. Well, what do you know? I've got more in common with this weapon than I first thought. So this effect, of course, is more effective against targets who have damage resistance. So there is a little bit of an upside to it. Sadly, half of the legendary effect is useless, because no matter which way you modify the Fencebuster out, it's never going to deal energy damage. So ignoring 30% of the target's energy resistance is absolutely meaningless. So that's a bit of a shame, and even though it does cut through 30% of the target's damage resistance, again, it's a little bit too slow and the damage isn't high enough for this to really be an option for a melee weapon. And if, for whatever reason, you were doing, say, a build where you needed a baseball bat, I would highly suggest that instead you use the 2076 World Series baseball bat. I do have a video on it, the link will be in the description with all of the other weapon guides. It is a much more fun weapon. But now back to Fencebuster. Hey, don't bust the nut over this, it's not that exciting. Although for those of us who do like collecting all of the unique weapons in the game, you must be sure to pick this one up. So yes, I have made my mind up. I am most certainly not on the fence about this weapon. And in regards to my rather harsh thoughts on the Fencebuster, I do hope that you didn't take offense. And here it is, the Fencebuster in action. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, I've been Camel, and this has been my walkthrough weapon guide for the unique baseball bat in Fallout 4's DLC Far Harbor, known as Fencebuster. I do hope that this video helped you out in some way, and if it did, feel free to click on the playlist button on screen. This of course will take you directly to my Fallout 4 Guides playlist where you can select the videos you wish to watch freely. Or you can check in the description, which will frequently be updated with links to new Fallout 4 Guides that I upload. If you love retweets of other wittier people's tweets, be sure to follow me on Twitter. The link will be in the description as well. And with all that said, I would like to thank you very much for watching. It's been an absolute pleasure, and I will see you very shortly in the next video. I'll see you there in a second.